Hey everyone, today we're going to talk about two-dimensional prefix summaries and how to perform submatrix sum queries in all of one time. So imagine you're given a matrix, a grid of numbers, and you're asked to find the sum of different submatrices as fast as possible. How would you do that? Let's look at an example. Say you're given this matrix and now you're asked to calculate the sum of several submatrices like this one, or that one. Of course, you could iterate over all the rows and all the columns for each of the query submatrices and sum up all the elements together, but that would be too slow. The goal is to answer each query in all of one time. We can achieve that by calculating a two-dimensional prefix sum array. In a two-dimensional prefix sum, each element represents the sum of all the numbers above and to the left of it in the initial array. So, if we manage to calculate the 2D prefix sum, we can answer any submatrix sum query very quickly. Let's first imagine that we have the 2D prefix sum array calculated and now would like to answer a query like, what would be the sum of all the numbers in a submatrix from 22 to 46? What would be the computationally fastest way of answering this query? You can pause the video at this point and try thinking of an optimal way to answer this query yourself using the 2D prefix sum array on the right. First, let's notice that the coordinate 46 actually represents the sum of all the numbers from 00 to 46, but it also contains a lot of redundant numbers which we don't need. We can get rid of them by subtracting the two rectangles which are represented in the prefix sum with coordinates 41 and 16. But wait, as we subtracted the two rectangles, the top left part was subtracted twice, right? Well, luckily, we can just add that part back by adding the corresponding element from the prefix sum at location 11. So our answer became the bottom right corner of the rectangle in the prefix sum, out of which we subtracted the bottom left and upper right corners, and added the upper left corner again, as it was subtracted twice. To account for negative values here for the left column minus 1 or upper row minus 1, we can add padding of zeros to the prefix sum. So after adding the padding, the calculations would be shifted by one in all positions. Okay, now that we know how to calculate the answer for any query having the prefix sum array, let's try to find an efficient way of obtaining the 2D prefix sum itself. Let's imagine that we go row by row from top to bottom and column by column from left to right for each row and try to calculate the prefix sum array at the current location. Keep in mind that the upper row and the leftmost column are padded with zero, so we don't touch them. When implementing this, we can initialize all the values of the prefix sum with zeros, then look through all the rows and all the columns, excluding the padded ones, and try to calculate the prefix sum for each cell. So at any current location, if we have all the previous values calculated, we can obtain the value of the prefix sum very similarly to how we would answer queries. We can add the value of the upper rectangle and the rectangle on the left while getting rid of the double counting by subtracting the upper left rectangle and finally adding the current value of the array. After this, we can easily answer any query by performing simple additions and subtractions on just four numbers, the four corners of the query submatrix. By the way, if you'd like to practice what we just learned, you can head over to Profound Academy and try solving some practical problems to really master the materials. I'll leave the link in the description below. Let's look at how the algorithm would work on several examples. Given the initial array, let's first fill the whole 2D prefix sum array with zeros. We then loop through each cell row by row from left to right and fill the values using the adjacent cells. For each cell, we add the value from the top and left adjacent neighbors, subtract the top left one, and add the corresponding value from the initial array. For the first row, the operations are very similar to calculating a one-dimensional prefix sum, as the top row is filled with zeros. Starting from the second row, the calculations make more sense, and this way the whole array is filled, while we apply only additions and subtractions to just four numbers per cell. Now that we have the prefix sum array, we can answer queries like what would be the sum of a submatrix from 11 to 53 using a single calculation. Similarly, the sum of a submatrix spanning the cells 01 to 55 would be calculated using the four corners of the requested rectangle with only a single operation instead of looping through all the values of the submatrix and adding those values together. So, in total, we perform rows times columns operations to calculate the prefix sum array, while also using rows times columns additional memory to store the array, and can answer any query in all of one time. So this makes the time complexity O of rows times columns plus the number of queries and the memory complexity O of rows times columns. So this was it for two-dimensional prefix summaries. If you found this video useful, don't forget to like it and subscribe to see more tutorials like this. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.